我们已经来到了雅歌的后面的最后的两章了。
We have reached the final two chapters of this book of Song of Songs.
虽然是后面两章，但我们还不知道要多几个星期才可以讲完，多几次才可以
讲完。Although it's the last two chapters of this book, but we don't know how many more weeks will take to complete it.
我们一系列讲雅歌。
This series of Song of Songs messages,
我们以基督跟教会的观点讲雅歌。
We study the book of Song of Songs from Christ's perspective.
我们说这个雅歌里面的主角新娘是代表着教会。
We know that the main character of this book, the church, is the bride of this book.
是代表着教会。
Represents the church.
它不是整个教会。
It does not mean the whole church.
它是教会中的一个有追求罪有一个有追求的人。
Referring to those within the church who are pursuing the truth. Truly.
然后他可以他追求到王后的地位。
They pursue God's word to the extent of being a queen.
一个王宫只有一个王后。
Palace only has a queen.
一个国家也只有一个王后。
A nation only have one queen.
但是呢，你注意到雅歌这里有提到六十王后，在前面的圣经里面六章的第八节有六十王后，八十妃嫔，并有无数的童女。
But in chapter 6, verse 8, there are 60 queens and 80 concubines being mentioned.
那么这就无形中就告诉我们，不是一个人可以追求到王后的位置在教会当中。
So it's not just one person who is able to attain the status of a queen in the church.
只要有追求的人都可以靠近王，都可以跟王最接近。
As long as those who pursue the truth faithfully are able to attain that status.
所以当使徒保罗在写提摩太后书的时候
，So when the apostle Paul wrote about Second Timothy,
他在人生的最后他说。
And towards the end of his life, he mentioned,
如今有公义的冠冕为我存留。
And there's a crown of righteousness that's being reserved for him.
然后，如果公义冠冕只为他存留的话
，However, if this crown is reserved only for him,
那不过是他得到。
It's only just achieved for himself.
但他接下去说
，He continued,
不但是为我存留
，It's not just given to me.
也为所有有追求的弟兄姐妹而存留的。
It's also reserved for all who pursue God's truth.
所以这就是鼓励我们。
So these are encouragement to us.
激励我们呢追求达到王后的地位。
To actually spur us to achieve the status of a queen.
我们在前面已经说过。
In the earlier part we mentioned before.
经过了许多的这一个高高低低的生命的这一个经历。
In the earlier part of this book, we actually look at the ups and downs of life.
那么这位新娘已经达到了像六章十节所说的。
So this bride has attained what we actually see in chapter 6 verse 10.
她向外观看。
It looks outwards.
就是她有远见。
She has a vision.
她如晨光发现，她好像晨光越来越明亮。
So she's one who appears like the dawn.
她美丽如月亮
，She's fair as the moon.
月亮是送光
，The moon gives light.
然后，她能够发光，能够送光，而且呢，她皎洁如日头
，It brings light and is bright as the sun.
她过圣洁的生活
，Living a holy life.
威武如展开旌旗的军队，六章十节。
So in chapter 6 verse 10, is as majestic as the stars in procession.
那么威武如展开旌旗的军队，就是说有征战。
So when we mention stars in procession, means
there's war. 所以这就是一个教会的，这个就是一个教会的高度了。
So this is the climax of a church.
有发展。
There's development.
会发光。
You produce light.
会送光。
You give light.
有圣洁的生活。
There's righteous life in it.
还能够征战。
Is able to fight the war.
所以就在这个样的情况中
，In such a situation,
他还能够工作
，He's still able to work.
他说：“我下入核桃园
，I go into the vineyard.
工作了
，to start the work.
然后达到了一个高度
，reaching a point, a high point.
第十二节说，六章十二节说
，Chapter 6 verse 12 says,
我的心将我安置在我尊长的车中
，Before I raise it, my desire set me among the royal chariots.
也就是我跟尊长同车。”
So I'm in the same seat as the royal chariots.
用今天我们的话说
，In today's terms，
他已经跟基督同步伐了。
We're already in the same pace as Christ.
以那么这样的一个进步的一个信徒。
This believer who has such a rate of development.
那么耶路撒冷的众女子就喊着回来回来，苏拉密尼。
The various daughters of Jerusalem, in verse 13, come back, O Shulamite.
6:13. 回来回来，苏拉密尼。
Come back, O Shulamite.
我们在前次说他得到了一个苏拉密这个名字。
So we actually studied how this Shulamite name came about.
苏拉密尼是平安的意思。
This name means peace.
它是女性的平安。
It's a peace referring to the female.
男性的平安就是所罗门。
The masculine version will be Solomon.
所以回来回来，苏拉密尼。
So come back, O Shulamite.
他已经得到一个名字。
She has gained a name for herself.
当然，这个名字是神给她的。
And this name is given to her by God.
圣经也应许我们。
The Bible also teaches that.
一个追求的信徒。
A pursuing believer.
我们都神都会赐下给我们一个新名。在启示录的圣经哪里那么说了
？In the book of Revelations, God has given a new name upon these
believers. 回来回来，苏拉密尼，你回来回来，我们观看你，
come back,
使我们得观看你。
Come back, O Shulamite, come back, that we may gaze on you.
结果新娘就问了
，So the bride asked,
为什么你要看苏拉密尼
？Why do we look upon Shulamite?
这位苏拉密尼其实刚刚开始的时候也是很平凡。
At the beginning, this Shulamite started life ordinary.
然后生命也是逐渐的长进。
And her life grew at a steady pace.
有时候进步，有时候退步。
There are some ups, there are some downs.
生命有时候在高峰，有时候在低谷。
Sometimes we are at a high point, sometimes we are at a low point.
虽然一直到今天，有了苏拉密尼的这样的一个新名。
Till today, even though there's a new name Shulamite.
但其实你要看我什么呢？
But how do we look at it?
是不是像看两组人跳舞的那样的一个舞，把它当作娱乐来看呢？
Should we just look at these two person dancing as a form of entertainment?
今天在教会中有许多的事情。
In today, in the church, there are many things.
我们看的话是用什么态度来看？
When we study these things, what kind of attitude do we show?
当我们看。当我们看教会里面的各种各样的这个侍奉
，We examine the different ministries in the church.
我们是用什么样的态度来看呢
？What kind of attitude should we present？
很多时候我们看见教会做见证的时候呢
？Sometimes we see how the church bear testimony.
请人来做见证
，invite people to share the testimony.
我们当作戏，我们当作娱乐来看。
Sometimes we just think that it's a show of entertainment.
因此我们看的不是那个生命。
We didn't look at the life really.
所以就因为这样，我们常常要请一些有名的人来做见证。
And because of that, many times we often have to invite famous people.
都是这些明星歌星来做见证。
Or these famous stars and singers to come.
其实当我们请明星歌星来做见证的时候呢
，Whenever we invite such group of people to come,
其实我们就等于在看。就要把它当作娱乐来看了。
We are really taking it as a form of entertainment.
明星歌星的改变。
These stars and singers, the change in their lives.
我们在座的许多的弟兄姐妹也曾经有这样生命的改变。
Among us, brothers and sisters, our lives also changed at some point in time.
但我们为什么不把这些弟兄姐妹生命改变的弟兄姐妹看着？他们神在他们身上的那个奇妙的工作。
However, why don't we see the work of God in their lives?
所以这里就在提醒我们。
So here it reminds us.
所以在聚会当中
，in the midst of this service,
任何的活动
，any activity,
我们应该是敬拜羔羊
，we should be worshiping our high lamb,
而不是娱乐羊群
，and not just entertaining our sheep.
来到第七章。
In chapter 7,
我们上次已经提过一点了。
Previously, we already discussed.
现在多了一个新的称呼。
Here, there's a new man addressing.
王女啊
，Prince daughter.
王女啊，把王跟女，把王跟女放在一起。
To even include the prince daughter over here.
可见这位新娘
，So this bride,
她已经不但是跟尊长同车第十二节。
So in over here, the prince daughter is already at the same seat at the royal chariots.
那么就是说跟这个尊长同一个步伐，跟基督同一个步伐了。
Meaning to say that they are the same pace as the royal chariots like Christ.
他也是跟 这个王放在一起，他的名字王女排在一起。
So you actually have an equivalent status of a king and queen.
我们看见这个就是同跟主跟基督已经同同步伐，同身量，同步伐，同身量。
So it's a keeping in the same step and stature of Christ.
所以王女啊，你的脚在脚在鞋中何其美好！这是新郎再一次的赞扬这位新娘。
So in chapter one, it says your graceful legs are like jewels. This is how the bridegroom actually praised the bride.
也就是基督在赞扬教会，赞扬这位有追教会中这位有追求的这位信徒。
So it's actually how Christ has praised the pursuing believers of a church.
王啊，你的脚，王女啊，你的脚在鞋中何其美好。
Your graceful legs are like jewels.
你的大腿圆润，好像美玉。
So your graceful legs are like jewels.
是巧匠的手所做成的。
It's like the work of a craftsman's hands.
那么这个称呼，这个王女的称呼，超越前面所有的一切的称呼。
So this addressing as a prince's daughter, it surpasses all that I've mentioned before.
前面有我的妹子，我的佳偶。
In the previous chapter, there's mentioned my lover.
你可以看第五章二节。
Chapter 5, verse 2.
我的妹子，我的佳偶，我的鸽子，我的完全人。
My beloved, my darling, my sister.
那么很多的称呼前面。
Many different addresses in
front. 但是这个王女超越前面的各种各样的称呼。
But this old prince's daughter surpasses those previously.
那么，所以这位可以说这位佳偶、这位美人、这位新娘。
So this bride that we're talking about
已经追求到一个生命的很高峰了，生命的高峰了。
She's already pursued the truth to the climax of her life.
以致有了新名苏拉密尼。
And she has achieved a new name, Shulamite.
也有君尊的地位了。
It's a very esteemed, glorious status.
跟王有同样的身材，同样的身量。
It's an equivalent status and stature of a king.
这样的一个身材身量，其实也就是我们每一个信徒应该追求的目标。
For such a high position and stature is what all believers should pursue.
你的脚在鞋中何其美好。
How beautiful are your saddle feet?
脚在鞋中，脚，这个脚穿着鞋，这表示是一个行动。
The feet being worn on the sandal is an action.
那么这个行动对我们来说就是传福音的行动。
This action we are referring to is evangelism.
就是侍奉的行动。
It's an act of service.
就是参与的行动。
It's an act of participation.
所以告诉我们是我们该追求的方向的。
It talks about the direction of our pursuit.
在今天冒着雨来做礼拜，这是好。
So in the midst of the rain, we come forward to serve.
这是好。但是，亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，But dear brethren,
不止于此。
It's not just that.
我们仍然要做传福音的工作。
All of us must participate in evangelism.
我们要侍奉。
We must serve.
我们要参与。
We must participate.
这是我们应该继续追求的目标。
This is what we ought to do.
当教会庆祝百周年的时候
，When the church will celebrate the 100th anniversary.
什么时候庆祝百周年
？When will we celebrate the 100th anniversary?
2019年过去了
，2019 will be gone
soon. 2020年就在前面
，2020 is right before us.
由2021
，2021
2022
2022
2023
2023
再过四年
，Four years later,
教会就是百周年了。
The church will be 100 years old.
当教会庆祝百周年的时候。
When the church reaches 100 years anniversary,
但愿我们坐在这里的每一个人
，We are all seated 4 years later.
不单单是做礼拜
，Not just those worship.
做礼拜是一种参与
，Worship is participation.
但是我们盼望更能够参与更多的事工
，We wish that we participate in even more works.
前面这些穿着丝袍的，他们参与了诗班
，The choir members were seated right before us.
我们当中有人参与了在长执会的工作。
Some of us have participated in the council work.
有人参与了组织学的事工。
Some in the Sunday school ministry.
我们更恳求恩主。
We plead with the Lord.
让我们有更多的人参与教会的工作。
That even more will come to do God's work.
其实有很多可以参与的。
Actually, there are many areas to serve in.
退休会的时候，教会退休会的时候，我们可以参与。
In the church retreat, we can join in.
教会的这一个，教会的其，教会的有时候。 教会有一些一些各种各样的工作，有团契，或者是有训练营、训练会，我们都可以参与。
We can participate in the various works of the church.
还有有时候我们有布道会、培灵会，我们都可以参与。
Sometimes we have gospel rallies, revival meetings. We can all join in.
我们有五百多，平时有五百多人聚会。
We have usually about 500 in total who come for service.
可是当我们来一个布道会或者培灵会的时候呢
？When we come to a gospel rally or revival
meeting, 我们大概只有三分一的弟兄姐妹参与。
We only have one third of the attendance.
我们那三分二没有参与。
The two thirds are absent.
我们求主帮助我们。
May God
help us. 让我们有了新的方向、新的目标。
Have a new direction. Have a new target.
而且圣经应许说
，And the Bible teaches that
我们侍奉者的脚中是何其的佳美，以赛亚先知的话。
The prophet Isaiah
侍奉者的脚中何其佳美。
The prophet Isaiah mentioned those who serve the servant's feet are fitting in his sandals beautifully.
好了，接下来你的大腿圆润好像美玉。你的大腿圆润好像美玉。第七章的第一节。
Okay, chapter 7, verse 1. Your graceful legs are like jewels.
我们说我们用基督跟教会的观点来解雅歌。
We actually use the perspective of Christ and the church to talk about
this book. 这个是用灵意解经。
This is called spiritual interpretation.
然后灵意解经，如果用字义解经的话
，So we interpret it literally.
各位，如果你会发现第七章非常难解，如果你用字义解经的话。
If you just interpret it literally, chapter 7 will be very hard to understand.
因为照着原来的意思。
But we follow the original context.
他是在这个新郎在赞扬新娘的身体。
The bridegroom is appraising the body of the bride.
这不但是爱情的话语，更是爱情的一种行为。
It's not just a language of love, but the action of love.
所以你很难，你要怎么解
？How do we study it?
你的大腿呀
？Our thighs.
你的肚脐呀？
Our belly button.
然后呢，你第三节你的两乳啊。
Our breasts.
那么怎么解
？How do we explain this?
但是感谢上帝。
But praise God.
我们知道。
We know.
基督跟教会在圣经里面就是这个丈夫跟妻子在圣经里面就是预表基就是象征基督跟教会。
So we mention Christ and the church. We actually is an analogy for
夫妇就是象征基督教会。
The relationship between husband and wife is that of the Christ and Church.
所以我们就从基督的教会这个观点来解。
Therefore, we approach this
from point
of view.
而且我们觉得很有意思。
And we find that it's meaningful.
你的大腿圆润好像美玉。
Your graceful legs are like jewels.
那么大腿是指什么
？What do these graceful legs mean?
大腿是站立的。
These graceful legs is for standing up.
站立的就是立场了。
As to make our stand clear.
基督徒应该有立场。
A Christian should have a firm stand.
那么言论就是完全，言论可以指作完全。
Their words be complete.
那么美玉就是宝贵。
A beautiful means precious.
所以我们的立场是言论的，是完全的，一个完全的立场。
So our stand is a very complete, steady one.
我们庆祝耶稣降生。
We celebrate the birth of Christ Jesus.
而为什么我们说，为什么中文在英文可能翻译不出来？中文我们说为什么降生？降生从天上降下来。
In English, so we say, Christ descending onto earth.
为什么不说出世？我们为什么把它说成降生？因为它从天上降下来。
We mention descending instead of just being given birth.
他是天上的君王。
From the heavens, he's king.
这是我们的立场。
This is our stand.
有人说不是。
Someone says no.
他是民间产生的一个革命家，一个改革家，一个革命家。
Someone said that he's just a mere reformer.
我们不，他是天上来的。
But we say that he's from the above.
我们说他是童贞女所生的。
We say that he's born a virgin.
可是人家说不是。
But some say no.
是童贞女，不是童贞女，有什么关系
？What is the difference between virgin and no
virgin? 今天有人这么说。
Some people say this,
因为他们不能够接受耶稣是童贞女所生的。
Because they cannot accept that Jesus is born of virgin Mary.
但是弟兄姐妹们
，But dear brothers,
我们的立场就是这么站稳。
Our stand is this clear.
他是天上降生下来的一位君王。
He is a high king descending from the
above. 他是童女所生的。
He's born of virgin Mary.
所以这个就是立场。
This is our stand.
你会在整个生命的过程中，你在追求，你在做基督徒的人生当中。
In our life of pursuing Christ.
如果你是有追求的基督徒
，If you are one who pursues God's word.
你会发现有许多的时候呢
，You see that many times.
你很多人会来挑战你的立场。
There are many people who will challenge our faith.
当你立场站不稳的时候
，We are weak in our stand.
有在这个教会。
And we are in this church,
我们很可惜在这个教会
while we are in this church,
就有人被邪教的风吹走了
Pity, there's people who are being swayed by
就有人被异教的 被异教的这一个说法来动摇了
Their faith is wavered by false teaching
所以我们需要立场
So we need a clear stand
而这个立场不是我信主的时候就有了这个立场
It's not that at the point of believing we already have a clear
stand 这里说是巧匠的手所做成的
He mentions that it's the work of a craftsman's hand.
这样一个坚定的立场
Such a firm stand.
是多年你在这个教会
It's after many years that you were in church.
然后借着教会的讲台
And through the church pulpit.
借着教会的这个教导
And the teachings on the pulpit.
把我们操练琢磨
To train us, exercise us, mold us.
磨练而成为有一个有立场的人
Into a believer who has a firm stand.
所以这是巧匠的手所做成的
All done by the work of a craftsman's hand.
七章二节
Chapter 7, verse 2.
你的肚脐如圆杯
Your navel is like a rounded goblet.
不缺调和的酒
Who never lacks blended wine.
你的腰如一堆麦子
Your waist is like a mold of wheat.
周围有百合花
And circled by lilies.
这其实是新郎照着原来的意思，是新郎在赞扬新娘的身体。
So this is the original meaning of how the groom praised the bride.
但是因为我们用基督跟教会的观点来解释了。
Because you approach this from point of view between Christ and church.
肚脐是什么
？So what does navel mean?
肚脐如圆杯。
So your navel is like a rounded goblet.
肚脐其实就是一个喂养，一个当这个当胎儿在母亲的。怀里的时候
，So this navel you are talking about is how a fetus or infant fetus is nurtured.
在母亲的肚子里的婴孩是不能够用嘴吃的。
It gets nutrients from the mother.
可是这个孩子，这个胎儿怎么长大
？And how does this fetus grow?
所以都靠着肚脐啊，靠着肚脐从母亲的身体上得到营养。
So it gets its nutrients from the mother's belly button.
所以肚脐本身就是得到营养、得到喂养的一个地方。
So this navel is a channel for us to gain nutrients.
你的肚脐如圆杯，不缺调和的酒。
A navel is like a rounded goblet that never lacks blended wine.
所以一个长大有生命的基督徒
，So a believer who is grown up,
他得到喂养，得到酒的喂养
，is being nourished by the wine.
然后呢？你的腰如一堆麦子
，and the waist is a mound of wheat。
一样的，也不但得到酒的喂养，也得到麦子的喂养。
Likewise, just like blended wine is also being molded by wheat。
那么酒是什么？麦子是什么
？So what does wine and wheat mean？
我们说从属灵的意思来讲
，from the spiritual context，
酒其实指作圣灵。
The wine is referring to the Holy Spirit。
所以我们以弗所书有句话
，In Ephesians，
不要醉酒。
Don't be drunk
要被圣灵充满
，but to be filled by the Holy Spirit。
我想很奇怪这句话，不要醉酒，要被圣灵充满。
This thing is very strange. Not be drunk by wine, but be filled by the Spirit.
我可见酒跟圣灵是有关系的。
So we see that there's a link between wine and the Spirit.
原来跟喝了酒以后
，So after drinking wine，
他就有胆量了。
So he has a courage.
不敢讲话，变得有敢讲话了。
Suddenly there's a guts.
所以一样的，不敢传福音，我们勇敢传福音了。
So from at first we don't dare.
那是圣灵的工作。
That we dare to share the gospel of Spirit.
所以不要醉酒，要被圣灵充满。
That we filled with the Holy Spirit.
所以今天我们得到圣灵在我们里面来帮助我们。
So as you're filled by Spirit to help us.
那麦子是什么呢
？And what does wheat mean?
麦子其实就是可以解释成道。麦子就是道。
Wheat means the word of God.
所以，这整句话第七章的第二七章二节的整句话的意思是什么？
So what does this entire verse 2 is trying to say?
王女的身体
the body,
就是基督长成的身量
The body of the prince's daughter being Christ
是借着酒和麦子就是借着圣灵和圣道来喂养
True wine and wheat is like the word and the spirit to grow.
周围有百合花。
Surrounding and
circle by the leaves. 然后结出百合花，我们讲很多次，百合花就是圣洁的生命。
So you actually mentioned that lilies is living a holy life.
然后结出圣洁的生命。
To bear a holy life.
所以今天我们的声量，
our stature,
今天我们的高度，
our stature,
属灵的高度，
our spiritual position,
是借着圣灵跟圣道来喂养。
It's actually through the spirit to groom us.
这个圣灵跟圣道喂养的结果。
So this holy word of God and the spirit to grow us,
就是有了圣洁的生命了。
It's helping us to achieve a holy life.
所以基督徒被人，一个基督徒跟人掺在一起的时候呢，他一定被发现到的。
When a believer is among the crowd, they'll be noticed.
因为许多人讲肮脏的话，他不讲。
Many people may say a foul speech, but he will not.
因为许多人看肮脏的图片，他不看。
Many people see unclean pictures, but he will not.
因为许多人赌博，他不赌。
Many people gamble, but we are set apart.
所以表现出来的就一定是圣洁的生命。
So what we present here is a holy life.
所以借着圣灵跟圣道，
so through the word and the Holy Spirit,
得着喂养之后，
after being nourished,
我们表现出圣洁的生命，
we present a holy life.
七章三节，
chapter 7 verse 3,
你的两乳好像一对小鹿，就是母鹿双生的。
Verse 3, your breasts are like two fawns, twins of a gazelle.
那么两乳可以指作两个胸，两胸。
So this breast, meaning breast, chest.
两胸就代表感情了，胸怀代表感情。
The bosom is like referring to a relationship.
但是你说，你问。
But we ask.
这个两乳也是母亲在喂养，她母亲在哺乳，在喂养她的孩子。
It's also, physically it's talking about the mother nursing, the baby.
两乳可以解成，也是解成喂养吗？
Can this nursing be considered as nourishing?
灵异的解经，
spiritual speaking,
当然可以。
Of course, we can.
但解经不但要合真理，
but when we interpret the Bible, not just we fulfill the truth,
而且要合理了。
It must be reasonable.
因为刚才我们已经用肚脐解释喂养了。
Because early on we already mentioned navel to be being filled, being nourished.
所以现在的两乳就不再解释成喂养。
So here the two breasts will not talk about nourishing.
两乳就解释成这个胸怀、胸襟、感情、感情了。
So it mentions the relationship among people.
所以不这所以这个那么两乳好像一对小鹿，就是感情好像小鹿是什么意思呢？
And we say that the breasts are two fawns, being a relationship, what does that mean?
小鹿是指着活很活泼的。
Two fawns meaning it's very active.
那我们的感情要非常活泼。
Our relationships must be very active.
好像说我们的感情有爱。
The relationship has love.
我们会爱，爱得不得了。
We love to such a crazy extent.
会表现出爱。
We'll present love so much.
当我们感情表现出欢喜、喜乐的时候，我们会喜乐得不得了。
When we express our love, we'll be so joyful.
可是无论我们爱得不得了，或者喜乐得不得了，
no matter how extreme our love may be,
无论我们表现出怎么样的感情，
no matter what kind of expression that we give,
下面一句话说，就是母鹿双生的小鹿。
Here it mentions the twins of a gazelle.
什么意思呢？
What does that mean?
当双生是表示平衡。
Twins of a gazelle.
前面已经解释过了。
Means of being balanced.
所以当我们有感情的时候呢？
So when we have a relationship,
这个感情是需要平衡的。
This relationship needs to be balanced.
所以基督徒，
so、
我们不是爱，我们不是，我们 不能比方我们在对人，我们或者对我们自己的孩子，
dealing with people,
或者组织学老师对他的学生，
or Sunday school teacher treating their students,
或者牧师在牧养他的会友。
When the pastor shepherding the sheep,
他不能够爱这个恨这个的。
Can you just say hate this and love this and hate that?
他必须平衡。
He must find a balance.
当我们说爱神，我们也要爱人。
We say we love God and love man.
当我们说爱自己，我们也要爱邻舍。
We love ourselves, we love thy neighbor.
当我们说爱教会，也要爱家庭。
We love the church, we also love our family.
这个就是平衡了。
This is balance.
所以我们需要有感情。
So we must have a feeling, a relationship.
感情就得平衡。
This feeling needs to be balanced.
所以你读圣经里面啊，有很多告诉我们说，我们要端庄。
So in the Bible, it says you must be appropriate.
自守。自守，节制啊，所有的这些自守啦、节制啦、自制啦，这些都表示我们需要平衡。
So you must be self-control, and in all actions, you must be balanced.
所以感谢赞美上帝。
Thank and praise the Lord.
这段圣经就让我们看见什么
？So what does this portion of the scripture tells us?
我们看见我们的立场，
we see our position,
我们的行动，
our actions,
我们的立场，
our stand.
我们的吸收，我们的喂养，就是圣灵跟圣道。
Are we receiving our absorption from God's word?
还有我们的感情。
Our feelings.
所以感情接下来是什么呢
？So what does feelings lead on to?
我们说一个人呐、啊，圣经里面说，我的心呐、啊，你要称颂耶和华。诗篇103篇一节。
In Psalm 103, it says, "My heart looks up and praises the Lord."
我的心啊，你要称颂耶和华。
My heart calls out and praises the Lord.
箴言4:23说
，In Proverbs chapter，
你要保守你的心。
We must protect our hearts.
胜过保守一切。
More than anything else.
因为一生的果效就由心发出来。
Because our life effects all stem from the heart.
我们也讲过很多次了。
We mentioned many times.
但圣经说，我的心呐、啊，不是到底是指着什么。
In the Bible, when you say heart, what does it mean?
或者说，我有时候说我的灵魂，有时候心翻译成我的灵魂。
Sometimes our heart means our soul.
那么到底是指着什么
？So does it exactly mean?
你说心在哪里？
Where is
our heart? 我的心
啊。Our heart.
你说心在这里。
Our heart is here.
不对，这是心脏。
No, this is the organ, the heart.
心在哪里？我的心啊，你要称颂耶和华。
My heart praises the Lord.
你想想哦，应该是我们的头脑吧
？So we think, oh,
所以你说心在这里。
So our mind is here.
不是，心也不在这里。
But no.
这里是头或者头脑。
This is our head, our brain.
道理说，我的心啊，你要称颂耶和华。
So how we say we praise God?
可是称颂是口啊。
We use mouth to praise God.
我的口啊，你称颂耶和华，我们明白。
We say use mouth to praise God, we understand.
可是我的心啊，你称颂耶和华，不明白。
We say use heart to praise God, we don't.
到底心是指哪里
？So what does the heart mean?
所以我们就得诉诸这个，就得。从宗教心理学来说了
，So you must look upon the psychology point of view.
宗教心理学的心就表示我们一个人的思想。
So you actually studies our thoughts.
我们一个人的意志
，our will，
我们的感情
，our feeling.
这个就是心
，this our heart.
心代表全人呢
，heart encompasses a lot of things.
我的心啊，你要称颂耶和华
，our heart praise the Lord.
就是我不但我的感情。我的感情来称颂赞美耶和华
，Not just we use our feelings to praise the Lord，
但是我们的意志，
<Our will. S 2>
我们的意志，还有我们的思想
，our thoughts，
我们赞美耶和华什么
？What do we praise God for？
我们要有思想，不是乱赞美的。
We must have a thinking，
今天很多人在做礼拜的时候
，When many people worship，
人家举手他就举手
，When someone raise their hand，
人家摇他就跟着摇
，When people shake they
摇什么不知道。
They don't know why you're doing this.
就是跟着群众这么做。
You just follow blindly.
不对的。
It's wrong.
我的心啊，你要称颂耶和华。
Our heart praise the Lord.
我思想，我知道为什么我在做这件事情。
I ponder and wonder why I do this.
我意志，我做这件事情。
My will leads me to do this.
然后我的感情投入做这件事情。
My feelings dwell in me to do this.
所以这里就让我们看见了。
So here it helps us to see.
有思想。
There's thinking.
还要有意志。
And there's will.
所以第四节了。
In verse four,
你的景象好像，你的景象好像这个象牙台。
Your neck is like an ivory tower.
你的景象是什么
？What does that mean?
我们也解释很多次了。
You also explain multiple times.
景象就代表意志。
Our neck means our will.
我们的意志，好像象牙台，就是非常的镇定。
So our will is as strong as ivory tower.
如果照着字面来解释啊
，You just interpret literally。
我想这个新娘的身体也真的，到底会美吗？景象好像象牙的台那么大。
So we actually describe the bride's body as a
tower。我们也不知道照字面要怎么解释。
You don't know where it will lead to。
但是这里照着属灵的意思。
But we follow spiritually。
象牙台就是 象牙就必须要经过琢磨，经过操练的。
The ivory tower elephant's teeth has to go through training.
所以意志也是应该，我们跟着意志也是应该经过锻炼的。
So will must go through training.
所以这个经过锻炼的意志呢
？So what does this ivory tower going training mean?
象牙台就是非常的坚定。
So ivory tower means very firm.
意志不动摇
，unwavering stand.
我们信主第一天开始
，from the first day we believe in Christ.
一直到在这个世界的最后一天。
Until last day of breath on earth,
我们的意志不动摇的。
Our will will not waver.
我们信主信到底。
We trust the Lord to the end.
我们侍奉主侍奉到底。
We serve the Lord to the end.
我们跟主跟到底。
We pursue Christ to the end.
我们做礼拜，每个礼拜来做礼拜，做到底。
We attend church to the very last.
这个是景象如象牙台。
This is what it means like being an ivory tower.
眼睛像西斯本巴特拉并门旁的水池。
So he continues saying, "Your eyes are the pools of Heshbon by the gate of Bath Rabim."
西斯本是城的名字。
Heshbon is actually the original name.
巴特拉宾是这个城的城门的名字。
The Bath Rabim is the name of the gate of the city.
在古代的城门常常有水池。
In the ancient city gate, there's always a pool.
常给人家方便取水。
For people's convenience to get their water.
通常这个水是很清净，很清澈，很明净的。
This water is very clear and pure.
所以你的眼睛好像西斯本，好像巴特拉宾门旁的水池。
So your eyes are the pools of Heshbon by the gate of Bath Rabim.
所以这位王女
，So this queen，
她的眼睛是清澈明亮的。
This queen's daughter, her eyes are very clear.
也就是眼睛看得十分清楚。
Her eyes can see things very clearly.
然后她的鼻子呢
？How about her nose?
鼻子是仿佛朝大马士革的黎巴嫩塔。
It's like the Tower of Lebanon looking toward Damascus.
这些都是当时的地理的名词。
These are the geographical names at that time.
鼻子，我们知道鼻子呢，是大鼻子。是朝大马士革的这个黎巴嫩塔。
So this nose is facing Damascus.
那么鼻子是黎巴嫩塔，有人说黎巴嫩塔就是黑门山。
Oh, when the nose referring to Tower of Lebanon is the
意思就是高了。
Means a high position.
这个可能是一个形容词，形容它高，好像高。然后呢，朝大马士革。
And the nose is pointing towards Damascus.
大马士革就是我们知道后来新约啊，保罗到大马士革的路上就遇到了主了。
So it's actually in New Testament when Paul met Jesus at Damascus.
所以换一句话说，这个鼻子是有朝大马士革就是有了方向。
So when we say nose pointing towards Damascus, we have a direction.
所以鼻子又高又美又有方向。
So nose is high and beautiful, has direction.
刚才说眼睛很明亮。
When we say our eyes are clear.
现在说鼻子和这个有方向。
Now we say our nose has direction.
也就是这位王女。
This queen's daughter.
这位王女不她这位王女呢不但是意志啊意志坚强，景象如象牙塔，意志坚强。
So this queen's daughter, not only It's her neck like the ivory tower.
然后她眼睛明亮。
Her eyes are very sharp and bright.
就是眼睛看得清楚。
Which can see things clearly.
鼻子有识别力，鼻子有方向，能够辨别出方向。
Nose has the direction to discern the direction.
能够分别是非。
To discern the right from the wrong.
我在想，基督徒也是很重要的。
As a Christian, it's important.
我们要有意志。
Must have a strong will.
我们的眼睛要清楚。眼睛要看得清楚。
Our eyes must see things clearly.
所以我们要眼睛看得清楚，什么是最重要的
？We must see clearly what is important.
今天在我们面前一大堆东西要我们选择。
Today before us, there are many things to choose.
有一些是有永恒价值的，有一些是没有永恒价值的。
Some things contain eternal value, some don't.
我们需要看清楚什么是有永恒价值的。
Now see clearly what things are eternal.
然后我们鼻子要有分别的力量，识别力。
Our nose must have a differentiating effect.
很多时候我们读一篇讲章。
Many times when we read a sermon.
或者我们听一篇道。
We listen to a sermon.
我们需要有识别力。
Must be able to differentiate.
这篇道把是不是真的把神的道讲出来了
？Is this sermon fully expressing God's truth?
还是这篇道虽然是讲，虽然它也称为讲道，但它的道带有毒素，带有错误。
Although the message is also a sermon, but there are some that are toxic.
我们需要分别，需要有识别力，也需要清楚。
So we must be alert enough to differentiate.
所以这位王女就是如此了。
So such is this prince's daughter.
我们看见她的胸膛，她的胸膛是她的感情是平衡的。
So and we also learn that her two breasts are balanced.
她的意志
feelings are balanced.
她的意志是坚强的。
And her will is strong.
我们说心不但是意志。不但是感情，心还是什么呢
？Not just we say the heart contains the will, our thoughts, but what else does it say？
心还是包括思想。
The heart also contains our thoughts.
所以，请看第五节。
Let's look at verse five.
你的头在你身上，好像加密山。
Your head crowns you like Mount Carmel.
那么，你头上的发是紫黑色的。
Your hair is like royal tapestry.
王的心因这下垂的发柳。
The king is held captive by his tresses.
这些是谁的话
？Whose sayings are these?
请看第七章的第一节，那说新郎说的。
In chapter 7 verse 1 it says the groom.
新郎就是指着基督说的。
These words are spoken by groom who is the Christ.
基督说你的感情是平衡的
，are balanced.
你的意志是坚强的
，your will is firm.
那你的思想呢？
How about your thoughts?
你的头就是指着思想。
Our head referring to our thoughts.
在你身上好像加密山。
It's like that of Mount Carmel.
你的头上的头发是紫黑色的。
Your hair is like royal tapestry.
那么我们先解释头是思想。
So let us explain what thought.
加密山是丰满的山，一个有很多这个草的山，意思是。很丰满，很生长，很丰满的山。
So Mount Carmel is a place that's endowed by a green grass, very very vast.
所以意思就是这个思想很丰富。
So these thoughts is filled. Is
然后头发我们也是解释过了。
The hair we also explained before.
头发我们解释成能力是不是
？Hair we also explained that
在前面几章。
The earlier chapters.
因为我们从参孙的头发被剪去之后，他就失去能力。
We see that when the hair of Samson was being cut off, he lost his strength.
所以他这个头发就代表着能力。
So this hair meaning the strength.
那么这个头上的头发是紫黑色的，就是代表这个思想可以带出力量的。
So this hair that represents thoughts, he carries strength.
所以一个有思想的人
，So someone who has thinking,
他也真的是会有力量。
He really also have strength.
所以那些在从像国家的领导人
，so the country's leaders，
像一个大机构的领导人
，big companies leaders，
他们都是有思想的
，they all have their，
所以他们有那个能力，他们有能力
，they have power, they have strength。
但是能力呢？这里说能力要怎么样
？Here, what does it talk about strength？
王，因为你垂下来的头发，王的心就被你绑住了。
So the king, the heart is actually held captive by his tresses。
所以下垂的发柳就是那个头发垂下垂的发柳的意思就是垂下来的头发。
The hair that's being laid down means being strength.
头发有能力。
The hair which has strength.
但头发如果没一直站起来的话
，But if the hair stands up, what does that mean?
它不顺服。
It doesn't submit.
下垂的头发。
The hair that is being.
今天如果你很有能力来服侍主。
Today, if you have a lot of capability to serve God,
教会都很欢迎所有的弟兄姐妹有能力的弟兄姐妹参与教会的事工。
The church gladly welcomes all those who are willing to serve the Lord.
会唱歌的人唱诗歌。
Those who are willing to sing, join the choir.
会教导的人教导。
Those who can teach, go teach.
会带领的人带领。
Those who lead, do so.
会组织的人组织。
Those who can organize, do it.
这是能力。
These are strengths.
但无论是唱诗、教导、组织。
Whether is it singing, teaching, or leading,
做事
doing works,
这些能力都得下垂，意思说这些能力都得顺服了。
These abilities must have a part of submission.
你会唱诗歌
，we can sing hymns,
但你不顺服指挥的指导
，you do not submit the conductor's leading.
结果全部都唱得很和谐，你一个人声音特别突出。
So everyone sing in unison except you.
啊，你特别突出。
You're very outstanding.
Outstanding, 你特别突出。
You're very outstanding.
我告诉你。
I tell you.
这样的能力是没有用的。
Such power is useless.
所以必须下垂的发柳，就是垂下来的头发，所有这些能力都得顺服带领。
So when you say the hair is being laid down, means all our acts of service must have an act of submission.
同样的道理，主是蛮有能力的。
God is full of power.
如果你不顺服，他可以用权柄叫你顺服。
If he doesn't submit, God will make us submit.
但是问题就是，
But the problem lies,
主更愿意顺服的人。
Those who are willing to submit.
所以当我们一顺服，我们又有能力。
When we submit, we'll have power too.
主的心就被这个有能力又顺服的人的绑住了。
So our hearts, our will are being held captive.
我相信大家都能明白这是什么意思。
I believe we will understand this.
就是主才可以用这样的人。
Therefore, God can use such people.
对，感谢上帝。
Thank and praise God.
前面这几节。
The earlier few verses.
让我们看见基督是主。
Let's help us to see Christ is Lord.
教会要顺服基督。
The church must submit to the church.
就好像我们一直常常读在以弗所书五章说，丈夫是主。
In Ephesians, we say that the groom is a Lord.
丈夫是主。
Yep. Groom is a Lord. Husband.
啊哈，丈夫是主，那妻子要顺服上丈夫。
And the wife must submit to the husband.
好，这个。其实这个在讲王女，这位王女她的生命。
So she talks about the life of the prince's daughter.
然后讲完了第五节以后
，After verse five，
七章六节
，Chapter seven, verse six。
我所爱的，你何其美好，何其可悦，使人欢畅喜乐。
Verse six, how beautiful you are, and how pleasing, O love, with your delights.
这仍然是新郎的话。
This is also the words of the groom.
这仍然是基督的话。
It's also the word of Christ.
所以到了这样的一个身量。
So until this depth.
一个身材，一个身量。第一节到第五节。
From verse 1 to 5, we already mentioned the stature.
所以新郎就说话了。
The groom starts to say,
啊，我所爱的，你何其美好，何其可悦，使人欢畅喜乐。
So how beautiful you are, and how pleasing, O love, with your delights.
换句话说
，In other words,
到了这样的一个境界，新郎赞赏他。
In such an extent, the groom praises.
他是一个成熟的基督徒。
She's a mature Christian.
他跟神的关系非常好。
Her relationship with God is very good.
他不但跟神的关系好，他跟人的使人欢畅喜乐，他跟人的关系也是一样的好。
Not just being good with Christ, but also good among people.
这是何等的重要。
This is utmost important.
雅各书，当我们研究了整本的雅各书以后
，When we study the entire book of Song of Songs,
雅各书的确是一本很激励人心的书。
It's a book that lifts us up.
特别是在追求个人生命的成长。
Especially for people who pursue God's word.
当你想想看。
As you think about it,
刚才的所描写的
，all that's been expressed earlier，
王女
，the prince's daughter，
她是有行动的
，she has action，
她有传福音，她有侍奉
，she preaches， she serves，
她是得到喂养的
，she's being nourished spiritually，
圣灵和圣道常常喂养她
，by the spirit and God's word。
那么圣道就是我们一直的追求，我们听到，我们研究自己读圣经，研究真道。
So God's word is something that we personally also pursue.
然后我们有圣洁的生活。
We live a holy life.
然后呢，我们有这个平衡的感情。
And our feelings are balanced.
我们有坚强的意志。
A strong will.
我们有看清楚的眼睛。
Our eyes are able to see clearly.
我们有能够识别对错的弊子。
We can differentiate the right from the wrong.
所以啊，对了，那么然后呢
？After that,
我们有思想。
We have thoughts.
我们还有头，我们还有坚强的意志。
We have a strong will.
还有这个思想。
We have thoughts.
还有能从思想展现出来的能力。
From thoughts comes strength.
然后这个能力愿意顺服。
Strength that is willing to submit.
以致我们成为什么？主所爱的。
So that we become one loved by God.
成为美好的信徒。
To be a beautiful Christian.
不但 是神所爱的，也是人所喜欢的。
Someone who is loved by God and delighted by people.
所以在追求生命的长进。
As he pursue a life of growth.
雅各书会帮助我们很大。
This book, Song of Songs, will help us greatly.
我们不知道还要多少次才能够讲完。
We don't know how many more times we will then finish.
但是我们既然已经来到这个地方
，But since you have arrived here,
我们一定要把它讲完。
We must continue to expose.
到了第七章第八章的时候
，Towards chapter eight,
有那样的一个激励人心的这一个里头的这一个真理啊，激励人心的这个真理啊。
The word of God that continues to push the hearts of people.
真的是会帮助我们的生命长进的。
It will help us in our spiritual growth.
我们曾经在开过雅各书的一些教会。
We actually look at some churches who preach on the Song of Songs.
得到如此的反馈。
We actually have a response.
我们感谢上帝。
And we thank the Lord.
我们祷告。
Let us pray.